This video is sponsored by Wizards of the Coast and TCGPlayer.com. Thank you both so much for supporting me in making this video. Are you ready for the spiciest core set of all time? Because Core Set 2020 is turning up the heat. This is the second core set to be released since their reintroduction in 2019. Core sets typically make use of existing keywords or abilities rather than introducing new ones, and they don't have an overarching plot line, though they do sometimes reference existing characters or lore. In this set, we get to see an old favorite planeswalker, Chandra Nalaar. And of course, the planeswalker, Chandra Nalaar. This set has three Chandras in it. Why does this set have three Chandras? Because she's on fire, and she plays into the set's major archetype of elementals, like this one. The other planeswalkers in the set are Ajani, the big kitty from the Gatewatch, Mu Yanling in her first ever printing within a set, Soren Markov, the vampire guy, Vivian Reed, the closest thing Magic the Gathering has to Steve Irwin. You might have noticed that mix for one mythic rarity planeswalker in each color, and then two additional planeswalkers being the other two Chandras, which are rare and uncommon. The set also has one legendary creature per color. Sephara, who can be played on turn 3 without too much fuss. Atemsis, with an alternate win condition having to do with the cards in your hand. Vilis, who draws cards when you take damage. Dragaseth, a dragon who can burn up to 3 targets for huge amounts of damage. And Gargos, the hydra that lives to fight things. There's also a colorless legendary creature, Golos. Golos is weird because it works best in a deck with all 5 colors, and it makes a fun commander in a 5-color EDH deck, despite being a colorless artifact. Core Set 2020 also has mythic rare creatures for each wedge. Wedges are 3-color combinations which can be identified on the color wheel by taking 2 adjacent colors and combining them with the color across from them, making a triangular wedge. Fun trivia time! The 5 wedges were officially named in the Cons of Tarkir block back in 2014. Abzan gives us Kethis, an elf who synergizes with legendary creatures and planeswalkers. Jeskai gets into the spirit of things with Kaikar, a bird wizard who generates flying spirit tokens, which can be sacrificed for mana. Sultai's Yarok is a life-linking, death-touching horror, also an elemental, that doubles up on your enter the battlefield abilities on all the permanents on your side of the battlefield. Yes, that does include explore triggers. Bardu brings back Kalia, who we've seen previously as a commander in a pre-constructed deck, and just like last time, she flies and she's great at fetching angels and demons and dragons, oh my. Temur gives us a whole new flavor of Omnath. Each time we see this elemental blob, it gets a new color added, going from green to red and green to red and green and blue in this set. This Omnath works great with all of the elementals in the set and deals a powerful punch with its enter the battlefield ability, as well as buffing a creature every time a land enters the battlefield. Lands entering the battlefield also trigger the abilities of 2 other cards in this set, Dread Presence and Field of the Dead. Both of these cards are worth looking into because Scapeshift is currently in standard. There's also one more 3-color legendary creature. Rien, Angel of Rebirth, is a Naya angel, and she works best with other multicolored creature cards. You won't find this card in packs, as it's only available in paper as a buy a box promo, or in arena as a craftable card. Each color pair also has a powerful uncommon card in the set, and I recommend keeping an eye out for them when you're drafting. There's also a creature in each color that has protection. Protection is a keyword which hasn't been seen in quite a while. Protection prevents creatures from being blocked by, dealt damage by, targeted by, equipped or enchanted by a card of a given color. This mechanic applies to spells and creatures controlled by either player. The coolest of these protected creatures is the uncounterable Shifting Ceratops, which can be given haste, trample, or reach for just 1 green mana. There are also removal spells that name the colors opposite from them on the color wheel and make for exceptionally powerful sideboard cards. Like most sets, Core Set 2020 has a few reprints, so if you see a few familiar faces, don't be surprised. Wait, was that a Leyline of the Void? There are Leylines in this set! These enchantments can be landed on the battlefield before the first turn just by having them in your opening hand. There's 1 Leyline per color, with the white, blue, and black Leylines being reprints, and the red and green Leylines being brand new cards. Each color also has a mythic rare Elemental Knight. The Cavaliers are powerful creatures with both enter the battlefield effects, and effects that trigger upon death. And that's Core Set 2020. I hope you all enjoyed this video, as I'll be making one for each of the new sets as they release. As always, you can catch me live at Twitch at twitch.tv/Amazonian. Thank you so much for watching.